Hey guys, so it's been over 6 months since I purchased the Timo Black Mirror, and that video happens to be one of the most popular videos on this channel. So first of all, thank you guys so much for all this support. So I've been using the scale regularly over the past 7 months, and therefore I want to give you guys my updated semi-long-term review. All right, let's get into it. So Timo is a coffee product company that was founded back in 2012 by several coffee lovers. They initially received some recognition for their manual handheld coffee grinders. And since then, they have expanded their offerings to other coffee-related products with really aesthetically pleasing designs. I'm actually very curious to try some of the other products out. However, since a majority of them are only sold in Asia, it makes obtaining them a little bit difficult. Anyways, back to today's product, which is the Timo Black Mirror. I've been using this scale regularly for the past 6-7 months. Since the first review I made about the scale just over 6 months ago, a lot of the things that I said remains unchanged. However, I know that a lot of shoppers out there are looking for sort of a more long-term or semi-long-term review to help with their purchasing decisions. That's why we are making this video today. So the first thing that I want to update in regards to the Timo Black Mirror, well, it's actually less of an update, more of a clarification. So when I initially reviewed the scale, I purchased both the white as well as the black version. And as I mentioned in the previous video, the display on the white version that I got was extremely hard to see, so much so that it was really difficult to read a majority of the numbers that was on the scale. So therefore, I have to keep just the black one. However, since then, a lot of viewers have actually purchased the white version, and they mentioned to me that to them, their white version's display was just fine. So it's completely possible that it might have been an issue with just the one that I received. However, if you guys are looking to purchase the white one, please go ahead and keep that in mind. And overall, I still think that the black ones offer a bit more contrast, so it will make the display a bit easier to see. And one more thing I want to mention before I get into the meat of the review is regarding the calibration. So there has been a couple comments just asking me about how do one go about just calibrating the scale. So first of all, I really don't think it's necessary to calibrate the scale on a regular basis, especially if you are a home user. If you have watched my IKEA Lunar review video, I did compare the IKEA Lunar to the Timo Black Mirror, and during which time I placed the IKEA calibration weight on the Lunar, and you can see that it was pretty calibrated right out of the factory. So if you do want to calibrate your Timo Black Mirror, what you need to do is hold down the timer button on the left hand side and just repeatedly press the power button until you get to a page where it says the word zero. Now this might take a few tries, especially when I try to do it on mine. It does take quite a bit of tries for it actually to land on that page, but if you just keep doing it, you'll eventually land there. And once you get into the calibration mode, what you need to do is first put on a 1 kilogram or 1,000 gram, followed by a 2 kilogram or 2,000 gram calibrator weight. Cause you know, everyone just have those lying around the house. So anyways, if ease of calibration is a major deciding factor for you, then I would recommend that you just go with the IKEA Lunar scale, because that comes with a 100 gram calibrator weight right out of the box, and the calibration mode is a lot easier to get to. But once again, I would like to emphasize that for a home user, a regular calibration is most likely not needed. But I'll leave it up to you to decide what is important for you. All right, with all of those things said, let's jump into the main part of the review. I'm going to try to keep this part concise just by going over the stuff that I really like about the scale and some of the things that I think could be improved upon. So let's start off with the things that I like. First and foremost, I think this scale is very budget-friendly, especially when you compare it against the IKEA, which I think is the main scale that the Black Mirror should be compared against. Number two, this scale charges via USB-C, and per single charge, the battery lasts quite a while, and for me, it's about a month in between charges, which makes it very convenient. Number three, this scale has a really nice frosted surface that is fingerprint and scratch resistant. After 6 months of usage, there are pretty much no marks on the scale surface whatsoever, even though I have collected quite a bit of dust on the rubber padding. However, on the flip side, this material might also be a con for some of you guys out there, as the IKEA comes with a much more premium ceramic or a metallic coated surface. However, I do want to mention that the material on the IKEA scale will get dinged up and marked up a lot faster than the material that is used on the Timo Black Mirror. So keep that in mind when you're shopping around as well. The next thing that I really like about this scale is its large surface. Especially if you are using this for a pullover, the surface can really accommodate for most of the brewing methods that you guys are using at home. Next, I gotta talk about the auto start function. This function in particular is one of the major things that I was searching for when I was trying to find a budget-friendly version of the IKEA Lunar. It will allow the timer to start automatically when it senses a change in weight. And that could be quite useful if you are trying to time your shot or time your pullover at the precise moment. Lastly, one thing that I really appreciate this scale have is that it goes up to 200 grams of max weight. Now, of course, you'll rarely go up to that 2000 gram of max weight. However, on my other scale, which only goes up to 1000 grams, sometimes when I'm making specific beverages that require adding ice, adding syrup, and other ingredients that are not just coffee, there was a few times when it reached the maximum limit and just gave me an error message. So with a 2000 gram max weight, it will ensure that you have a scale for pretty much any brewing scenarios. All right, with the things that I like out of the way, let's move on to a couple areas that I think there are room for improvements for. The first thing, and probably also the most obvious thing, especially if you have used the IKEA Lunar scale before, is the overall responsiveness of the unit. The touch as well as just the overall reading speed is just not as snappy as the IKEA. However, in its defense, this responsiveness issue is also present in most of the other scales out there on the market, with IKEA really being the exception. But you gotta consider that the IKEA is really built for a professional environment and it also costs several times over. The next is the actual material itself. I mentioned in the previous video that when I first opened the Timer Black Mirror scale, I was quite pleasantly surprised just by the look of the scale. I think it looks beautiful. However, when I picked it up, I was immediately taken back a little bit just by the sharp edges, and that still stands true over the past several months. I have swapped back and forth between the Timer Black Mirror as well as the IKEA Lunar scale a couple times, and every time when I come back to the Timer Black Mirror and I pick it up, it's always this edge that kind of just stands out to me. And if I just bring it closer to the mic, I think you can hear it. Right? You can hear this sharp edge that you kind of always brush against, and this is throughout the entire four corners. So for future versions, I think if they just made one with a beveled edge on the side, just like how they have it on the surface over here, then I think it will make the scale a bit more premium feeling. So the next thing I think can really be improved is the calibration function. And obviously there are some users out there that really want the calibration function. So I think if Timer can include a calibration tool in the box, that will make this scale more appealing for those people out there. And the last thing I think I need to mention is the fact that this scale only have one measurement unit, which is in grams. Now, this is not a huge issue if you're only using the scale to brew coffee, as most of the recipes are stated in grams. However, since the scale have the surface space, I think it would be nice if we can include a couple other measurement units so that this can be used as a general purpose kitchen scale, or for those rare times when your coffee recipe does call for an ounce or whatnot. So after using both the IKEA Lunar as well as the Timer Black Mirror, I still believe that the Timer Black Mirror gives you a great deal of value for its price. It gives you the essential functions that you would like from the IKEA, but removing some of the more premium features to bring down the price tag. As of yet, I still have not found another scale in this price range that have this reverse design that protects the scale from spills. And lastly, I would just like to address one more time regarding the two common complaints that I found on Amazon. Number one is the relatively loud beeping of the scale. As I stated in the previous video, I do not found the beeping to be that loud, and you can just simply mute it by holding the timer button. So to me, that is not an issue at all. And number two is due to the solid color of the scale. Some people mentioned that they were not able to find the power button on first try. Honestly, over the past 6 months, I have not able to find the power button on first try. So for those of you out there that think that might be an issue, I really don't think you should sweat about it. And finally, my verdict stands the same as before. If you're longing for an IKEA scale and you don't want to pay the crazy high price tag, then I really think the Timer Black Mirror is a scale for you. And for those of you out there that have purchased the Timer Black Mirror, please let me know in the comment section down below on how you feel about the scale. Again, I hope that you find this 6 month update to be helpful. If you are new here or have not subscribed to our channel yet, please take a moment and hit that subscribe button. And of course, it will really help out the channel if you also hit the like button and share this video with others who will find it to be helpful. And also be sure to follow our Instagram page as well. That's it for this episode. Thank you guys again for tuning in, and I'll see you in the next one. Bye.